So how do we implement reusable barriers correctly? This is how. The idea here is that the value for releasing the barrier will not be the same for all instances of the barrier. Even instances when release becomes zero, odd instances are going to release when release becomes one. So the idea is that we never really need to reinitialize the release. We just flip the release. Each thread now has a local sense, which is kind of what's the release that we should get in order to get out. So if we have two threads, 0 and 1, let's say that they started with local sense being 0. Now they're going to get here, and they're both going to figure out that the local sense is 1. Local sense is local to each thread, so each of them just sets a local variable independently, so this is not going to interfere with each other. Now, one of the thread will enter the counter lock, increment the count, and here, if the count is equal to the total, they will reset the count and set the release to local sense. So it sets the release to what we are waiting for. In this case, let's say thread 1 releases it to 1. That means that thread 0, when it incremented the count, didn't see the total at 2, it saw it at 1, and proceeded to exit here and enters this wait here. It's waiting now for the release to become what it thinks local sense is, which is 1. So it's going to spin until somebody puts 1 into the release. Eventually, thread 1 does that. So now let's say that thread 0 is stuck here. That was the problem with the previous implementation of the barrier. Let's say that we just don't read it fast enough. So we want to see a 1, but we don't check it fast enough. Thread 1 now proceeds to exit, finishes the work, and comes back to the second instance of the barrier. It now flips its own local sense to 0. Increments the count to 1, because we reset the count when we were releasing the first instance, checks the count, sees that it is 1, doesn't do this, unlocks the lock, and enters the spin here, but thread 1 is now checking whether the release has become 0, because it flipped the local sense. Now it's waiting for this value for the release. So they're waiting for different value. Note that the release is still the same as thread 1 left it in the first instance, so eventually thread 0 will check and see that the release has become 1, at which point it will leave. Eventually it's going to come here, change its local sense to 0, increment the count, see that it's 2, reset the count, set the release to 0 this time, and now thread 1 will be released. So by flipping the value of the release, instead of reinitializing it in each iteration of the loop, we avoid the problem that we had. So this barrier is reusable. We can synchronize on the same barrier over and over without risking deadlock situations.